Hallo alle zusammen und willkommen zu einem neuen Frag-Anja-Tag. Heute sprechen wir über Präpositionen. Als erstes ein Shoutout an Gizmo. Gizmo, hallo Gizmo 123243. Du hast ganz viele Fragen für mich beantwortet. You answered a lot of questions for me. Thank you. Und dann gibt es noch Luz La La La. Du hast auch ganz viele Fragen für mich beantwortet. You also answered a lot of questions for me. Also, danke euch. Thank you very much. Und jetzt geht's los. So, Mumal Malik, du hast gefragt. Can you help us understand these sentences, building words up, an, and so on? Das sind ganz viele Präpositionen, außer auch. Auch ist keine Präposition. It's not a preposition, but the other ones are prepositions. Und ich bekomme immer ganz viele Fragen über Präpositionen. I always get a lot of questions about prepositions. Präpositionen! Das ist ein schwieriges Thema in Deutsch. It's a difficult topic in German. In diesem Video möchte ich dir nur einen Überblick geben. In this video, I just want to give you an overview, so you understand the main concept. And then in other videos, I will show you the prepositions bit by bit. So, hier haben wir die Übersicht, the overview, die Übersicht. Als erstes haben wir hier links die Akkusativpräpositionen, rechts, on the right side, sind die Dativpräpositionen und in der Mitte sind die Wechselpräpositionen. In the middle are the two-way prepositions. Ja, das sind die Wechselpräpositionen. So they are kind of bisexual, die sind bisexuell. They either like the accusative or the dative sometimes. They can like both. Akkusativ, bis. I just give you the major meaning of the prepositions. I will make separate videos about them. So bis usually means until. For example, when I say bis morgen is until tomorrow. See you tomorrow. So bis is usually used together with other prepositions. For example, we often say bis zum 12. August. Until the 12th of August. Bis zum, yeah, and zum is a whole nother preposition. But it's still in the accusative column because, for example, you can say bis nächsten Dienstag, until next Tuesday. And nächsten oder nächsten, you can say it both ways, is in the accusative. Then we have durch. Durch means through. For example, wir fahren durch den Tunnel. We are driving through the tunnel. Den Tunnel, Akkusativ. Für, vor. Die Kerze ist für dich. The candle is for you. Für dich. Dich is in the accusative. Gegen, against. Sie läuft gegen den Baum. She runs or walks. Laufen can mean both things. Against the tree. So you see, der Baum, the tree, changes to den Baum. All right? Then we have ohne, without. For example, ich gehe ohne dich. I go without you. Ohne dich. Dich, again, is in the accusative. This is usually for time. Yeah? 12, for example, at 12 o'clock. But it can also be for around something. Let's do the same example. Sie läuft den Baum herum. She walks or runs around the tree. Den Baum. Often we add herum afterwards. I don't know why, but yeah. She walks around the tree. So, das ist Akkusativ. That's the accusative prepositions. Bis, durch, für, gegen, ohne, Kennst du nicht den Akkusativ, dann bist du wirklich dumm. There is a saying, I also made a separate video about that, you can check it out, I will put the links in the description. So, dann haben wir die Dativpräpositionen, das sind sehr viele, these are quite a lot. So, up means from. Up is a tricky thing, so usually for time, for example, yeah? So, for example, ab nächster Woche oder ab nächster Woche, starting from next week. But up can also sometimes be used with accusative. I will make a separate video about that, but usually it's with the dative, okay? Then we have aus, from, usually. For example, sie kommt aus der Schweiz. She comes from Switzerland. Normally, it's die Schweiz. Switzerland is feminine. You can imagine it like a woman. Switzerland, the country, is feminine. But with the preposition aus, it changes to aus der Schweiz. And that is because it's in the dative case. It demands the dative. Then we have außer, except for. Außer. For example, sie gehen alle zur Party außer dem Mädchen. They all go to the party except for the girl. So das Mädchen, the girl, changes to dem Mädchen, außer dem Mädchen. How would you say except for the woman? Die Frau changes to what, the feminine one? Zu der Frau. So you would say außer der Frau. Okay? And you can also just say names, außer Anja, except for Anja, or something like that. Then we have bei, usually means at. For example, ich bin bei meiner Oma. I am at my grandma's place. Ich bin bei meiner Oma. That's also the dative ending. So, or how would you say, I am at my grandpa's place? Ich bin bei meinem Opa. So, mein Opa is normally, but now it gets the ending of the dative case, meinem Opa. Then we have gegenüber, means opposite of. For example, das Museum ist gegenüber der Apotheke. The museum is opposite or across from the pharmacy. Normally it's die Apotheke, but since it's dative, it changes to der Apotheke, gegenüber der Apotheke. How would you say opposite of the museum? It's das Museum. Gegenüber dem Museum, yeah? Das changes to dem. I made videos about all that. I also have a whole playlist about that. I will put the link in the description. Mit is the one that usually everybody knows for the dative. It means with. So, ich komme mit dir. I come with you. Mit dir. Dir is in the dative case. Before we talked about dich, which is accusative case. Dir is dative case. Mit demands the dative case. So it's mit dir. With you. Nach can also mean several things. Nach can either mean to. For example, wir fliegen nach Deutschland. We fly to Germany. But nach can also mean after, in terms of times. For example, nach einer Stunde, after 1 hour. And there you see the dative case. Then we have seit, since. Ich lerne seit einem Monat. What am I learning? Right now I'm not learning anything. But let's say it's just French. Ich lerne seit einem Monat Französisch. I've been learning French for 1 month. So, seit einem Monat, it means, yeah, it's the dative case. You see that there. Then, von. Von is also a bit funny. Let me just show you one example where you see the dative case. For example, von mir, it means from me or it's mine. For example, die Flasche ist von mir. The bottle is mine. We say von mir. It's mine. Yeah? Of me, basically. Zu means to. This often contracts with dem, for example. Zu dem contracts to zum. So these are things that I all talk about in my videos, but just an example. For example, ich gehe zum Friseur. I go to the hairdresser or zu dem Friseur. Yeah? So pretty easy, right? So now we have the ones which are clear. So these ones always demand the accusative. These ones always demand the dative case. Then we have the ones in the middle, the Wechselpräpositionen, there are 9 of them. Yeah? Es gibt 9 Wechselpräpositionen. And they can demand either one, and that depends on something. And I have a separate playlist about that, which I will also link to. But just see here now. So we have in, and they are all local. Yeah, these are all the local ones. So in means inside of something. Then we have an, means zum Beispiel an der Wand, at the wall. Auf means on something, usually. Then we have neben, it means next to. Hinter means behind. Über means above or over. Then we have unter means under. Vor means in front of. And zwischen means between. I explain all of them in a separate video. So now, that's the thing which is a bit difficult. They can be either one. If you can ask wohin, where to. So it means there is a change of location. An object or person is first in one location, in location A, and then it changes to location B. So there is a change of location. So, and when this is happening, then you use the accusative. Yeah? Wohin? Akkusativ. Wohin means where to. For example, der Park. You would say, ich gehe in den Park. I go in the park. Den Park, you see, it's accusative. Then we have die Wohnung. Ich gehe in die Wohnung. I go into the apartment. Das Haus. Ich gehe in das Haus. It stays the same. You see, so die Wohnung stays the same. Das Haus also stays the same because it's in the accusative. They all stay the same except for the masculine one. Der Park changes to den Park. Then we have die Häuser is the plural. Ich gehe in die Häuser. It also stays the same. Now, the difficult one is the dative because they are all of them change. First we have ich bin in dem Park. I am in the park. So now you see there is no change of location. There is no movement, they often say. So you're just in the park, so then it's the dative. You can remember the dative is the lazy one. Es ist der faule Fall. The lazy case, der faule Fall. And you would just say, ich bin in dem Park. I am in the park. Bam. Ich bin in der Wohnung. So now die Wohnung, the apartment, changes to der Wohnung. I know it's weird, it's funny that it changes to the masculine one, but that's how it is. Then we have, ich bin in dem Haus. So das Haus is normally, it changes to dem Haus. Yeah. And then we have, ich bin in den Häusern. And now two things change. First, die Häuser changes to den Häuser, and then you add an N. Häusern. You see the N? Ja, da ist ein N. Seht ihr das? Da ist ein N. Den Häusern. So, wow. That was quite a lot, I know, but I have separate videos about all of these things. I will also make separate videos about these prepositions. If you also want to have the overview, please check out my website. You get a lot of free material there. And these designs we usually make in my academy to help my students or our students to like understand the whole concept in total. Yeah. So we have a lot of designs like that, and you can check the free training where I give you free German material and show you my academy. So, alles klar. Das ist alles für heute. Hast du noch mehr Fragen für mich? Do you have more questions for me? Dann frag für den Frag-Anja-Tag. So, Dankeschön. Und if you enjoy this video, please let me know, because I can make more about the prepositions. Dankeschön und tschüss. Schönes Wochenende.